What's going on, my friends? I am Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U, and today we're going to talk about whether or not Pushmatic panels are dangerous and whether or not you should be replacing them. As you're going along as an electrician, every once in a while you run into new stuff. You may come across these older panels called Pushmatic panels. More specifically, breakers that are Pushmatic. A lot of the panels are gonna say either Pushmatic, they'll say ITE, they'll say Bulldog, they might say Pushmatic, Bulldog, ITE, Siemens. Like a whole bunch of, whole series of, you know, as we do these videos, like Federal Pacific and Zinsco, you just see these companies get bought out, one company after the other. So it all started out, there was a company called the Bulldog Electric Product Company. We don't know a whole lot about their beginnings and when everything got started. There's just not very much documentation out there. There are drawings from like the early 30s. You can actually see like illustrations for product designs and stuff with that Bulldog company's name on these designs. But we don't really know kind of like where it all began and what the full story is. But what we can tell is that in the 50s, American homes started having these Pushmatic panels in them. And a lot of them would have this little Bulldog logo. And then later on, ITE bought them out. And then even later on than that, Siemens bought ITE out. But we do know that around, you know, the 50s era, that's when these things started to really pop up. In 1953, Westinghouse actually sued Bulldog Electric Product Company because they said that they had like infringed on some of the patents. And it was denied. There were like seven things that they said that they infringed on, and the judge denied all seven of them. So there's not a lot of drama like you would expect, you know, like Federal Pacific and a lot of the Zinsco failure rates and stuff that happened back then. There was never really like a huge product independent study or research or anything done on Pushmatic stuff to find if there were any product failures. But in the 1980s, like around 1986, you started to see problems come forth. So at this point, you know, a lot of these breakers that were being put in, panels that were being put in the 50s, they're getting 30 years old or more. So a lot of the problems are starting to arise. And what they're finding is a lot of the buttons themselves, they have a little flag mechanism that lets you know whether or not the breaker is tripped. Well, a lot of them would show that the breaker was off, but it was still on. So that's a really dangerous thing. You go and look at a panel and it's like, oh yeah, that breaker's off. No, you could still get shocked or, you know, things are still energized. So that was kind of a problem. And now again, I'm not saying that there's like a massive amount of these that were happening. There's no data on it. It was just that there were reports of it happening, and it seemed to be frequent enough that a lot of people throughout the electrical industry have a very divisive opinion on whether or not these are good or bad. They have a cool design. You know, it's a breaker that you walk up and you push a button. So it's like a lot of people really liked this style. I think it was just a cool style. In addition to that, there were these breakers are grease fed, which means that like for them to work, you have to push and kind of like cycle or exercise the breakers often over time to get that grease worked into it. And that's how they stay, or that's how they have longevity. Nobody's doing that, right? You go install a panel, you're not out there going and cycling the breakers to make sure that they're greased up. Nobody does that. So as you know, like 30 years, as these things age, they start to really stiffen up on the inside from the lack of grease. So that's another thing, is just being able to push them in and have them reset or test. It was really, really difficult. So there's just kind of complaints across the board. Then some people were like, well, it's not that big of a deal. Just take WD-40 and you can spray them in there and cycle them and it's all good to go. And it's like, yep. But really, like, should we really be using stuff that you gotta go pull out WD-40 to make sure it works? Like, for breakers in a panel, I don't think so. So this is why it's kind of a divisive issue. This is why some people are like, no, Bulldogs are like Bulldogs, man. They're great. They're fine. Don't worry about them. And other people are like, no, it's stupid. If you have to grease a fucking breaker, why would you keep it around? Just replace the thing. So that's the two sides of the argument. Now, the other thing that kind of tips the scale in the go replace these column is the fact that a lot of them were thermal trip only. So there's not a lot of mechanisms inside like we have in modern breakers where you have the thermal trip kind of part of the breaker, and then you've got the magnetic trip part of the breaker. So one will do an overloaded situation and another one will do a short circuit. These breakers instead just had a thermal bimetallic strip essentially that as it heated up just slightly beyond whatever its rating was, it would trip the circuit. But as far as there being any sort of like short circuit magnetic trip element, there was none. So the idea of replacing it kind of makes more sense to get newer stuff. There's newer technology out there. Plus, you can't put an arc fault breaker. There's no arc fault Pushmatic breakers that are being made, or, you know, like, so just updating everything to a newer panel seems to be a little bit stronger of an argument, in my opinion. Now, if you have Pushmatic breakers in your panel and you would just want to replace the breakers in a new panel, I don't see anything wrong with that. There's actually a lot of brand new breakers that are still being manufactured that fit into these older panels. There's a link in the description below. You can actually go to Big Electric Supply and get them. There's a discount code, ElectricianU. But they do make brand new breakers that address a lot of these problems. So what's the conclusion? Should we replace Pushmatics or not? It's my opinion that if there's nothing wrong with yours, if you go out to your panel and everything, when you test one of the breakers, it flags it as off, everything works, you have an electrician that's, you know, able to test whether or not all of these breakers are actually off when they say they're off, if nothing's really that difficult to push, like if there's really no problem, then really there's no problem. Again, there hasn't been a huge amount of research out there of independent studies or anything to show that there even is a huge problem. There were just some problems, and so it's, these products are so old and there's such new technology out that it just seems like a better idea to replace it. So in my opinion, I think these things should go. I think we should be putting in brand new panels, like, you know, Square D has, well, a lot of brands, but Square D, you know, Siemens, Eaton, we got Cutler Hammer, GE. A lot of these new panels have arc fault breakers. They have combination arc fault breakers. They have dual function ground fault breakers, surge protectors that specifically fit in with their panels. You know, like they're really well-designed modern panels with extra safety features. This is the stuff that should be in houses, not this old crap that I've got hanging up on the wall. I've got a whole bunch of panels just sitting on the ground that I haven't added up here, but I'm also afraid that I'm gonna do a video one day and this whole fucking thing's just gonna fall over and hit me if I start adding too much weight. But anyways, a lot of these older things, like we just need to nix these things. But I do think that if you don't have the money to be able to go like replace the whole thing, getting newly manufactured breakers to replace the old ones, if you've got one that's kind of janky and won't reset, get a new one. Like Home Depot's got them, you can go to Big Electric Supply, there's places where you can get them. So that's my opinion. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure that you do all of the things, the like, the subscribe, the join, the Twitter, Facebook, all the shit that I every time tell you. Love you crazy people. See you in the next one.
Discount music and video.